Warren's my niece.
We're not exactly talking Ginger Rogers here.
State of California versus Mark McCormick. Judge Hardcastle presiding. I found a lot of holes, Uncle Milt.
But I never make mistakes.
What's that?
I'm deposing you.
But,
please wait until I've asked a question.
Why are you shaking? What are you scared of?
I don't want you even thinking about her.
Now you're cooking.
Place to seek knowledge, growth. In the 93 years of our existence, young minds have sought nourishment from inside these walls. They have come from 50 states, young, eager, open, fresh, clamoring for ideals and wisdom. We have tried, as best we know how, to provide them with the fodder for what they seek. But now it seems that we have to brace ourselves against the tides of change. But the first time in the history of this establishment, a student is taking legal action against the university. An injunction has been granted prohibiting the building of the Calvin Morland Law Library in the present site of the Brass Rail Bar and Grill. This legal action has been instituted against this board, Calvin Morland, and the university. The ringleader of all this is a young man called Warren Wingate. And I want to get the little creep.
John, Warren Wingate's not a he.
What's that, Milt?
Warren's a girl.
Warren? Are you sure, Milt?
I'm reasonably sure, yeah. She was named after Earl Warren, Supreme Court.
I wonder whose brilliant idea that was.
It was kind of my idea. Warren's my niece.
But I've got to change my major. I mean, like, this whole thing was my father's idea. I mean, I wanted to major in phys ed. I mean, what do I know about small businesses? Huh, but God, you haven't met my father. I mean, do you know what he made my brother major in? Animal husbandry. I mean, the guy's allergic to cats. Do you know what I mean?
Look, I can appreciate the stress this is causing you, but Dean Whitmore's in a meeting. You'll have to come back later. Dean Whitmore's office.
Trying to drop your major too, huh?
Yeah, or flunk out.
Yeah.
My dad's gonna kill me.
Your dad? Oh, you haven't seen anything till you met my dad. Come here, I'll tell you about it. I spent the entire last semester studying for my Western Civilization finals, but old man Ferguson had a personal campaign against me. Flunked me anyway, right?
Tell me about it.
Well, You know, I pulled a few strings, rattled a few doors, got my major changed.
Wish I knew how you pulled that one off.
Well, you want to give me a phone number, I'll be happy to tell you, you know.
Hey, like, do you teach here or what?
Doing what?
I got in a lot of trouble in junior high. I don't date teachers. But, hey, thanks anyway.
Hey, how old do I look to you? 22? 23, maybe. I don't know.
Your niece has questioned Cal for over 2 hours. She's going to take depositions on all of us.
Well, I'll talk to her.
You'll have to do more than talk to her. You're going to have to get her to back off. It doesn't look good.
It won't be any problem, okay? She kind of looks up to me. I'll work it out.
Good. Until then, I don't want a word of this to get out anywhere.
So, old Warren's suing the university, eh?
That's privileged information.
Well, it's privileging all over campus, and word is she's winning.
This is not a football game. It's a legal action.
It's an end-around fake. 6 points and no Calvin Moreland Law Library. You know what? I'm on her side.
What do you know about it anyway? You never been in a library in your life.
I was in the snub-nosed Tony Memorial Prison Library. They had a lot of magazines in there.
Milt.
I'm sorry about this trouble, Cal. I'm going to go try find her now.
Well, I wish you luck. She's quite energetic.
Well, other than that, how you been?
Fine, considering Rick Benny's up on trial today. Murder one.
Rick Benny, didn't he shoot a cop?
Yeah, connected with organized crime. The press is all over this one. I'll be honest with you, Milt. I just assumed you were up on the bench instead of me. I'd much rather be playing golf.
Well, it's one of the benefits of retirement. Don't worry about my niece. She's a good kid. She'll come around. Never a day of trouble in her life.
For a yearbook, University of Illinois, 1942.
What hell's in a yearbook that's so important?
Just keep looking, all right? Someone's paying a lot of money to find it, not to ask a lot of questions.
She's 22 years old. What are you going to do, put her over your knee and spank her?
She's not 22 the way you were 22.
What's that supposed to mean?
It means I don't want you even thinking about her.
Oh, don't tell me you're still on that.
She's family, McCormick. That means out of bounds, hands off.
It was 6 months ago, Judge, and I'm telling you, nothing happened.
When nothing happens, you come in before 7 o'clock in the morning.
We were talking, that's all.
Hey, watch closely. I don't want you dating my niece, period.
Dating? Is that what you call a dinner, going out to a movie, then maybe stopping for a drink afterwards? Is that what you call it, a date? It was just very friendly.
Don't be friendly, okay? When she comes in the room, don't light up. Act like you do when you're around me. Be normal. Slouch. Complain, okay?
It wasn't even a good movie.
Listen, McCormick, she is working very hard trying to become a lawyer. Mm-hmm. Now, that means she's going to keep her nose to the grindstone because she's a chip off the old Hardcastle block, see?
Oh, boy.
You don't get to pass your bar exams without a lot of hard work and sweat.
Sure has changed since I've been there.
Right.
Look at that.
nose to the old grindstone.
So that what this is all about, huh? The law library?
Well, you got a lot of people very upset.
Well, maybe I ought to take Mark out to another all-night drive-in. That way you can go back to worrying about something else.
We just watched the movie, Judge.
Let me tell you something. This club has been here for 70 years. We already have a law library. They're just looking for another place to hang someone's name on concrete.
Warren, you're going around questioning the whole school board, taking depositions.
Come on, Uncle Milt. Who do you think these guys are? A bunch of white-haired, whiskered old fuddy-duddies who can't even remember what relaxing and kicking back feels like.
I'm on the board.
Oh, great. I got it now, huh? The old Hardcastle chill. No way. Forget it, Uncle Milt. It took me 20 years to get past it when Mom does it. What do you guys rehearse?
What do you think you're doing? Legal action? You're taking your clothes off in public.
It's called dancing.
Gene Kelly's dancing. This is
the 20th century.
What?
Nothing.
Look, I questioned Calvin Moreland already. I went over every detail of his college life. The guy cannot even remember where he hung out and relaxed. So what is he going to care about this place?
Well, that was a long time ago.
Oh, come on, Uncle Milt. You don't forget stuff like that. Tell me you don't remember Ruth, huh?
Milton loves Ruth.
Oh, Milton Hardcastle, the heartthrob of Sigma Chi.
I didn't put that there.
The senior law students figured out it was you when they looked in the yearbook. Milton Hardcastle and Ruth Lowenkowski, cutest couple.
I said I didn't put that there.
Look, Judge Moreland didn't exactly collect a lot of fond memories when he was in college. He just doesn't know what this place means to us.
But being one half of the cutest couple of 1950, you understand, don't you, Milton?
Stay out of this, McCormick. What do you know about fond memories?
Hey, this may come as a complete shock to you, but I had a youth too, you know. If they were tearing down the Starlight Bowling Alley, I'd have a heart attack.
Students come here to study, exchange ideas. They don't rent bowling.
That's my point. I mean, this place is just as much a part of our education as any classroom or some law library we don't even need.
Is it something you have personally against Calvin, or do you just want to take on the world in general?
Calvin, give me a break, Uncle Milt. I mean, like, now you're going to tell me this guy saved your life in the war, right? Oh, come on. It's like you guys are in the same club or something. The lawyers. What have you got, little satin jackets? Oh, well, we're going to keep the club, okay? And besides, who do you think taught me to take the world on once in a while, huh? You did.
Oh, well, that's okay if it's practical.
If it's practical. Well, I bet you didn't talk like that when you were taking Ruth up to see submarine races.
Hey, you can help me here, you know?
You're right. Listen, okay, what are you doing tonight? You want to go see a Clint Eastwood festival?
That's help. I didn't mean that.
Look, now that I know you're on the board of directors, let's get together and we'll talk about it.
Oh, what's that?
Well, I've been over it with the lawyers. I'm deposing you. Tomorrow at 10:30. Be there.
Warren.
And don't let the big brown eyes fool you. I'm a killer.
Ship off the old block.
What happened?
I don't know. I mean, I only had an AM radio in here.
It's too much damage for just an AM radio. Looks more like vandalism.
Hold this.
Look at this.
Well, what am I supposed to do now, huh? I mean, I got a show to do tonight. I gotta get home and tell Val that she can have her boyfriend over. I mean, where are the cops in this town anyway? How many donuts can you eat?
Hey, maybe somebody's got an axe to grind with you. You in some kind of trouble?
Why would anybody be angry with me? I mean, I'm only taking one university to court.
Yeah.
Maybe the board of directors started playing hardball, huh?
Wrong guys. They'd paperwork you to death.
I hate this.
Come on, leave that. Come on, come on. I'll take you home. Come on.
I can't wait till it's over. I've got moot court case coming up, then 3 more months, then the bar exam. Home free.
You gonna dress like that in court? You picked a case yet?
For moot court? Yeah. State of California versus Mark McCormick. Judge Hardcastle presiding. I found a lot of holes, Uncle Milt.
You're not serious.
I'm not?
Well, all right.
Wait. I want to hear this. Go on.
Well, there's a chance that you may have overlooked some precedents in Mark's defense.
Oh, really? Might have overlooked some precedents in my defense? If this whole thing is a mistake, Buster...
You never make mistakes. I never make mistakes.
It's all a matter of ownership. Now, you claimed Mark stole a car because he changed the registration to another name. But in fact, he was the owner all along. He was just dodging an insurance hike.
Yes.
Now, in Clancy versus California...
Clancy
versus California was cattle, not cars.
Don't worry about it, Mark. I think I'm going to get you off. Cattle, cars. I just got to fill in the blanks.
You gonna need a lift anywhere?
No, that's all right. Val's making chicken Mexicano tonight, so that means she's not gonna need the car, so I'll borrow hers. But thanks anyway, all right? Thanks, Uncle Mel. Bye. Hey, what are you guys doing in my apartment?
Ah! Hey! You okay?
I'm fine. Yeah, I'm fine.
Need her to come down and make a statement.
Yeah, well, give us a couple hours.
Yeah.
Tell Mike I want something on this guy right away.
Will do.
Sure you're all right?
I'm okay.
Well, you haven't talked for 10 minutes. I get worried, you know.
Did they take anything?
How could you tell?
Hey, you come on home with us. We find out what this is all about.
Thanks, Uncle Milt. But I still got a lot to do. I mean, I got to get this place back together again.
Hey, they broke up your car. They busted into your house. I don't want you here alone.
I'm okay. See, I'm talking and everything. Testing, 1, 2, 3. I'll be fine.
I'll tell you what. Why don't you go back, check out that guy we busted. I'll stick around here. I'll help her clean up. What's the problem?
McCormick, that is my only niece.
You get out of here. Come on. Get...
I can't believe him. He's incredible.
Well, he's kind of like a freight train, you know? He kind of gets on one track and stays there no matter what he runs into.
I mean, it was one day. What does he think? We're going to take one look at each other and fall in love?
Well, it's not that far-fetched.
Well, I mean, what are you, 30?
A couple of months shy. What about Carol Lombard and Clark Gable? They were, you know, same deal.
Carol who? Look, Mark, you're terrific. All I'm saying is that it's silly for Uncle Milt to worry about anything happening between us. I mean, I'm his niece, and you're the guy that works around the house.
I do. I do more than just work around the house. I'm right up there in the first wave, man. I'm driving the car, you know, dodging bullets. Someone's got to look out for him, right?
Mm-hmm. That's true, huh? I mean...
All right.
You put your life on the line sometimes, don't you?
Kind of goes with the territory, you know. Mm-hmm. Sometimes you just got to go with the flow, and that's what happens.
Doesn't it scare you?
Nah, I can't afford that. It slows the reflexes, mm-hmm. You know? Mm-hmm.
So, if I were to, like, move in real close and look into your eyes for a long time, maybe breathe a little deeper, move in to kiss you, that wouldn't scare you?
Nope.
And why are you shaking? What are you scared of?
Uncle Milty.
Uncle Milty.
Well, you turn up anything on that guy that tossed Warren's apartment?
Ah, I didn't have to. Name's Steve Rush. Works for Willie Lerner.
Hey.
Oh, I love it. I love it. This is my favorite part. Now you're gonna tell me something I don't know, huh?
I'm only working on a good guess.
Well... what reasons Willie Lerner got to be turning over your niece's car and her apartment?
That's a tough one.
Well, I'm game. Give me an easy one.
Okay, Willie Lerner runs most of the dope and gambling and prostitution in town. He's got a second in command named Rick Benty. Benty's up on a murder rap.
Yeah, but how does your niece fit into this?
The judge that's sitting on Benty's case is Calvin Moreland. Now, Warren is bringing legal action against the entire university, but specifically Calvin Moreland.
Are you serious?
Yes.
I love it. The whole school, huh? Well, well, Hardcastle blood all the way. Chip off the old block. Huh? Well, maybe when she was running a background check on Moreland, she turned something over, huh? Yeah, but what?
That's what we have to find out. I'll check with you later. Chip off the old block.
Not exactly talking Ginger Rogers here.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, you know, it's really hard to believe that you two are related. I mean, you have trouble keeping your footing on a wet floor.
Did you find anything when you went through the apartment?
No, not much. Just a couple of pictures of you and Warren's mom sitting on an antique car with you wearing knee socks. Needless to say, they weren't stolen.
out what it is that Warren's got that Lerner could want.
Well, she grilled Calvin Moreland for half a day. Maybe she dug up some dirt accidentally and doesn't know it.
Maybe. Maybe Lerner could bend Calvin to make a trial go his way. Ah, what dirt? I've known Calvin Moreland for years.
So what'd you think?
When do you have time to study?
Loved it, huh? God, I'm starving. Kathy, can I get a double cheeseburger, some french fries, chocolate shake? Do you guys want anything else?
No, thank you.
Warren, what do you know about Willie Lerner?
You gonna eat any more of these?
No, go ahead.
Warren, Willie Lerner.
What Willie Lerner? The criminal Willie Lerner?
The guys who went through your apartment work for Willie Lerner.
What are you asking me? What am I supposed to know about Willie Lerner? He kills people. I dance. Are you done with your drink?
No.
Look, I know you're not exactly crazy about my lifestyle, but dancing here hasn't really led me to the underworld. Give it another week. Thanks, Kathy. So what do you think Willie Lerner wanted in my apartment?
Look, Will, eventually they're gonna realize we took that from the apartment. We're drawing a lot of heat as it is. Can't we just put this on hold till after the trial?
After the trial's too late. We don't know if the girl went through that.
She went through the book. She would have blown the whistle already. She probably doesn't know anything.
She knows enough to bring Hardcastle into it. You know, this girl's causing us a lot of trouble. If she unravels this, we're in a mess. Rick could go away for a long time.
If, Will, if. She's a kid. We'll get Rick off.
Yeah? Well, I want to make sure. You get a hold of Harriman. Tell him where to find a girl and Hardcastle.
I'm telling you, McCormick, I don't have a lot of fans around here.
These are your people, Judge. Building full of lawyers.
Not these guys. These are defense attorneys. They're the guys that are trying to turn the whole system upside down.
Well, it'll be right up your alley. You had a few problems with it yourself.
Judge Hardcastle?
Yeah, I was just telling my friend here what a great job you guys do.
Thanks. We're ready to take your deposition now.
All right, now don't get rattled. She's only 22, Judge. It'll be like taking candy from a baby. Now go get her, Tiger.
You're not sure? Really, Judge Hardcastle, maybe I can prod your memory a little bit.
Oh,
Judge
Warren.
Hardcastle, this is a formal deposition. I'm sure I don't have to explain to you what that means. I'd appreciate it if you'd refer to counsel properly.
Well, Miss Wingate, I fail to see what relevance these questions have to the proceeding.
Thankfully, then, this isn't your court, and we didn't ask you for a ruling. I have a picture here captioned, "Sudsing Away Those Old Legal Blues." Can you identify this man?
That's me.
And the people with you?
Some guys from the Law Review.
Whatever happened to Terry Badham?
He's a federal district court judge.
Malcolm Everett?
President's Advisory Board.
James Newcomb. That wouldn't be State Supreme Court Justice James Newcomb.
That's him.
Where was this picture taken?
In the brass rail, but I don't see
the brass rail.
But if you're saying it,
I'm not saying anything. I'm just asking questions. Those old legal blues. What is that all about?
Every first-year law student is familiar with that term. It means packing a nation's legal history into 4 years. It means that you...
Could you speak up, please?
It means that you need a place to go where you can cool down and blow off steam.
Put things into perspective.
Right. But,
Please wait until I've asked a question. This university is part of a long tradition, a tradition that has produced some of the finest lawyers in the country, state Supreme Court justices, presidential advisors, and the brass rail is part of that tradition, part of the education itself. Thank you, that's all. Uncle Milt, I don't have my car yet. Could you give me a ride home?
No.
You set me up for it.
I learned from the best.
Now you know how it feels. Every time I went to say something during my trial, someone cut me off. So you might bring that up in your moot court case.
Well, to tell you the truth, we're not doing so hot, Mark.
Why? What happened to Clancy versus...
It's kind of technical, but what it boils down to is that the laws apply a little bit differently to people than to heads of cattle.
Oh, great.
Oh, Uncle Milt, I remembered what was missing from my apartment. I didn't even think about it until I went to open up your yearbook for the deposition. I remembered that I also had Judge Moreland's yearbook, and it wasn't there when I put the place back together.
What are you doing with all these yearbooks?
Research. Just trying to be thorough. Doing a little history on everybody I'm questioning, looking for holes.
find anything on Moreland?
I didn't even have to go through his yearbook. The guy had enough difficulty answering the questions I was asking him. You know, he can't even remember anything about college.
I got it. It all fits together. Willie Lerner has given up digging holes for people, and he has now gone into Grand Theft Yearbook. He got bored with killing people.
University of Illinois, 1942?
Right. Judge Moreland's alma mater.
And we don't have any idea what's in that yearbook except a lot of stiff pictures of people with crew cuts.
And Judge Moreland is trying one of Lerner's top men, Rick Benty.
There's got to be something in the book, guys. There's got to be. I bet that Lerner is hoping that he can dig up some dirt on Judge Moreland. Turn the screws a little bit, you know? Get him to go light on Benty.
Where'd you get the yearbook?
The university gave me the name of a guy. He's kind of a collector. I think we should call him.
No, she's right, Judge. That means Lerner already has something on Moreland.
He's starting to look that way. Sorry, Uncle Milt.
I'm sorry, Milt. This one's a backbreaker. Well, Miss Wingate, how goes the war?
Look, Judge, if you don't mind.
I'll take care of this one, Warren.
Something up, Milt?
Why don't you tell us what's in the yearbook? Hmm?
Pardon me?
Oh, come on.
Warren, shh.
Well, why don't you ask him why those guys were...
I said I'll do this. Cal, I think we got a little problem here.
We got big problems, Billy.
We didn't know the guy had a cannon in his truck.
It doesn't matter. This whole thing's coming apart.
Maybe we could take another run at Hardcastle and the girl.
No, we're moving on.
If you can't keep Judge Moreland in your pocket, Rick may go away for a long time.
Hey, Rick's dead already. I can't see everything I got going down the tubes for one guy.
I still think nobody knows anything. If that girl found anything in the yearbook, they would have busted the trial wide open by now. From where everybody's sitting, I'm sure Moreland looks bright-eyed, honest, and full of integrity.
I'm telling you, the guy's a liar. We're not going to sit on this, are we? I mean, I got my case coming up soon. I think we should call the cops and give them the facts.
What facts? We got a yearbook and a lot of guesses.
Pretty good guesses, if you ask me.
What are they teaching you in that school, anyway? What are all those signs and posters in your law clinic? Or does all that stuff just apply to the oppressed, as you like to call them? Listen, let me tell you something. Calvin Moreland is just as innocent until proven guilty as some guy that hasn't got a quarter.
I'm sorry.
All right. I want to get to the truth as much as anybody else, but I'm not going to close the lid on a guy until I know what's going on. See?
Maybe I ought to lighten up a little bit on Uncle Milt, huh?
Lighten up. Lighten up? Look who's talking. I've had dinner with you guys, remember? Isn't that right, Kimo Sabi? I mean, come on, you're no different from me. You know, I mean, how do you deal with him? You know he's right most of the time. He's the best damn judge that ever sat on the bench. Maybe we're just trying to bring him down to size. So don't lecture me about lightening up, okay?
Let me tell you something. I had a pretty good time the night we went out. I really did. I mean, right there in the middle of Creature from the Black Hole, thought that maybe it could work out between us.
You see, for a few seconds, I almost forgot that you are a Hardcastle. What is it with you two? Every time anybody says anything, you've got to jump down their throats. Calm down, Warren.
Now you're cooking.
On that note, let's go check out the yearbook guy.
1942 was a difficult year. I hope you haven't lost that book I gave you last week.
I didn't exactly lose it. It's just become kind of popular.
I should have another copy around. 1942.
Maybe we could help you find it?
I'll find it.
Is that why you collected all this stuff? Because you didn't fit in?
What do? You become a fan, a supporter. You tell the people who matter just how much they matter. It's got its points, you know. You'd think after 42 years, I'd give it up. I guess it makes me feel like I got some good memories.
What? I mean, he's not even in the book, right? He's afraid we're going to find out he never even went to the university.
No, he's right here. Fourth year law student, honors all around.
So this whole yearbook thing's been a dead end, then?
No, Cal Moreland is in the book. But I don't know who's sitting on that bench in the courthouse.
I'm not the only one that loses, Will. If this thing comes down on me, Rick's gonna do time.
Is that a threat?
No. No, it's a fact. Why don't you just take Hardcastle out of the picture? That shouldn't be too much for you.
I'm glad to see how much you value yourself, Cal. Now, to save you, you want me to take out Hardcastle, his niece, and McCormick, huh? You think you're worth it? It wasn't me who got you into this, Cal. It's your problem. You know, it wasn't me that faked your credentials. I don't even know if you passed your bar exam.
This is old news. It doesn't solve the problem.
So what do you keep asking me to bail you out for, then, huh? How far can I take it? I got the yearbook. We took a run at Hardcastle. Like I said, it's not my problem.
You know that they're going to make the connection between us. Now, if they get me, they're going to get you.
You let me worry about me, huh? Don't you have a trial to get to?
Thank you. Billy, we're cutting our losses. Get a hold of Harriman. There must be at least 100 reporters around that courthouse. He can lose himself in the crowd.
That's a recess. Court will reconvene at 2:30.
Cal died in a boating accident just after graduation. I was still struggling through junior college. It seemed like an opportunity.
You just picked up where he left off?
Cal was an honor student. He had all the credits and credentials. All I had to do was get a hold of his transcript.
So you never even went to the University of Illinois?
No. Cal's transcript got me to the bar exam. Now look, I may have started with Cal's record, but that's all. I passed the bar. I did the trial work. I made it to the bench.
Well, Lerner found out and put the screws to you for a favor.
About 10 years ago, he came up with the facts. I'd spent a lifetime building my career. The first favor was easy. It was a plea bargain for one of these men. At the time, it seemed like a fair trade. What do?
You call the police, Cal.
You know I'm dead, Milt. Lerner can't let this hang.
Not unless you take him down first. There's a lot of reporters out there.
There's Moreland.
Judge Moreland. Judge Moreland, is there any truth to the rumor that Benty is going to turn state's evidence? Yeah.
Judge,
just back off a minute. Back off.
Judge, back
off. I have a statement to make. After that, I'll answer your question. As soon as court reconvenes, I'm going to declare a mistrial.
Mistrial? What made you change your mind, Judge?
How do you feel about Benny going free?
When you think
there'll be a new trial.
Lerner's here. Lerner's here. He's over there.
Ticket. Can you fix this for me?
Are you
Thank you.
that's peace offering.
Thanks, Uncle Mel. I'm still not hungry.
Hey, your moot court was today. How did my case go?
You lost. As a matter of fact, it looks like Uncle Milt let you off pretty easy. Sorry, maybe if you had four legs and horns, huh?
Here you are.
What's this?
That's a statement from the university.
Da-da-da-da-da, in light of recent developments, blah, blah, blah. We have suspended our plans to erect a library on the present site of the Brass Royal Bar and Grill. All right, we whipped them!
This is not a permanent decision.
No promises, huh? So we'll just whip them again. I have a peace offering for you myself. I thought that since I had used your past against you, I would do something to make it up.
Oh, hello. How are you?
Does the name Milankowski ring a bell? It's been a long time, Milton.
Ruth?